Good morning, children. Everyone, open your environmental studies. We have started our animal shelter now. Everyone, open page number 62 in your textbooks. Page number 62. Previously, we have discussed about the terrestrial animals, arboreal animals, and aquatic animals. Okay. Terrestrial animals means they live on the land, and arboreal animals means mostly they live on their trees, and aquatic animal means they live in the water itself. Now, the seashore in page number 62. See. The seashore provides shelter to crabs, turtles and sea worms. They live under the rocks or make holes in the sand. So the seashore, see there, we can see the crabs and turtles, no? They'll make the holes or else they'll settle under the rocks, big rocks will be there, no? In that, okay. Seals and walrus are sea animals that eat fish and live around northern coast of Atlantic and Pacific Oceans. So these two, no, they'll eat the fish and they'll live, okay. And these two can be seen in the areas of Atlantic and Pacific Oceans. What are those two? Seals and walruses, okay. So also, no, is there on block C in your textbook. Albatross is a seabird. It spends its entire life flying over the sea. It visits the shore only to build a nest and lay eggs. It builds its nest with the soil and plants and lays a single large egg. So albatross is a seabird, children. Always it will fly on the sea itself. It will move to one place to another place, no? And it will lay only one egg that will be very big, and that it will lay it in the soil there. Okay. So shelter of other animals, sea. Animals like frogs, crocodiles, toads and turtles live in water. Crocodiles and turtles stay on land to lay eggs. So these are the animals which live in water. Okay, and these crocodiles and turtles are there, no? So to lay the eggs, they will come to the seashore, okay? And they will lay the eggs on the land, stay on the land and they will lay the eggs, okay? Frogs and toads lay their eggs in water. Even frogs and toads, they will lay eggs in the water itself, okay? Whereas crocodiles and turtles, they will come to the shore and they will lay the eggs on the land. Whereas frogs and toads, they will lay eggs in the water itself, okay? Camels live in deserts. Thousands of years ago, traders tamed camels and began to use them to travel across the deserts. So, camels. Mostly camels we'll see in the desert areas only, children. So, it is highly impossible to walk in the deserts. Why? Because it will be covered with the sand now, okay? And today the people of the desert still use a camel for milk, meat, wool and transportation. So they used to carry this businessman's, the trading will be there, no, children. So the traders, what they used to do, they'll have the camels along with them. They'll put all the luggage on the back of the camel and they'll move along with it. Sometimes they may be on the camel also, okay. Nowadays they are using the camels even for the milk, meat, wool and for the transportation. So for all these purposes they are using this camel, okay. Some animals live in grasslands which do not have much trees and heavy bushes to hide the creatures living there. Because of the open area and widely spaced trees, grasslands are homes to large herds of grazing animals. So some animals, where they live, children, they live in the grasslands for the hazing, for the eat and all, they'll go in a group, no, children, for that. Actually, a lot of grass will not be there, bunches will be there. So this some people will take this mobs to this group of shepherds to that place only, okay. And they don't have any particular place to hide themselves because they don't have the bushy areas or large number of trees over there, okay. Nocturnal animals, let us see. Animals that are active at night are called nocturnal animals. So the animals which are active in the night time, okay, they are called as what, children? Nocturnal animals. They can see very well in the dark, so their eyes are very beautiful. They can see in the night time, okay. During the daytime they rest in their shelters. Throughout the daytime they will rest in the shelters, and the night time they will start roaming, okay. Hamsters and guinea pigs are nocturnal in habit. They stay in their burrows during the day. Owls and bats too come out at night. See, these hamsters and guinea pigs, they are the nocturnal inhabitant. Means what, children? In the night time only they will see and they will try for their prey and all, for the food and all, okay. And here, they stay in their burrows during the daytime. Throughout the daytime, now what they will do nicely, they will sleep in their burrows. Owls and bats too come out at night. Even owls and bats also, they will come in the outside in the night time only, okay. Earthworms live under the ground. They come to the surface at night to eat. So earthworms also, they will come outside in the night time only. Daytime they will take rest. So they will come, they live in the holes, no, children, the burrows, no. In the night time they will come to the seashore, okay. To eat, they will come outside to eat. moths to come out during nights to collect their food. Even moths also. See, what are the animals? Hamsters, guinea pigs, owls, bats, earthworms and moths. All these are the nocturnal animals only. Why? Because in the night time they will come out and they will search for their foods. Okay. Nights to collect their food. A spider's web. So everyone, we are very much familiar with the spiders, no children? Because if 4 or 5 days we don't move to, if we did not visit any corner, no, what will happen? There a spider will form a web over there. It nicely will build one web. Okay. See, a spider's home is very easy to recognize. Yes, by seeing it, we can say that that is a spider's web. There are over 32,000 types of spiders living on the earth. Oh my god, how many types, children, here? 32,000 types of spiders are there on the earth. Okay, they live in almost every area from the hottest to the coldest. So they don't have the particular region, either from the hottest to the coldest region. In all the regions they will live. A spider spins a web with a type of silk which is formed in its body. So how the spider is spinning the web, children? From its body only one silk thread will be out, okay? And with that it is preparing its web, okay? The silk comes out as a liquid. It becomes solid when it comes in contact with air. So from its body the silk is coming, no, children? It will come under in the form of a liquid. When it touches to the, what is that, air, it will become the solid part, okay? The web has blobs of glue to trap insects. So if anything is fall on that web, no, small insects, they will be attached to that web. They can't come out from that, okay? A spider won't get caught in its own web. On its feet, it has a special oil. So it only will construct, no, it won't stuck to that because some special oil will be there to its legs, foot, okay? Now, here in page number 63, the natural environment of a living thing is called its habitat. Put a tick mark against B, children. Which bird stitches leaves together with thread, wool or cotton? That is a tailor bird. Which bird does not make its own nest? That is cuckoo. Animals which spend most of their time on trees are called, arboreal animals. Where do horses live? They live in stable. Where do a starfish live? On the sea rocks. And today, see, yesterday you have completed 2 question answers, no, children? Today, describe the nests of a weaver bird and a tailor bird. Distinguish between terrestrial and aquatic animals. So today's your homework task is these 2 questions, children. For these questions, you have the answers in your workbook. Write them with good handwriting. Give finger gap between word and word. Have a good day, children. Thank you.